bottle of Macallan Distill Your World New York Edition has just sold at auction for $250,000, people. $250,000 for a bottle of Macallan Distill Your World New York. Why? Well, in this video, we're going to take a look and find out. Well, you know, let's get the marketing gumph out of the way. The Distill Your World series is, according to Macallan, an endeavor to document and share with the world how we seek knowledge and insight, how we understand what is happening to the planet and take inspiration from it. So, what is that? What does that mean? The bottom line on this and the cynical approach on this would be that it's fancy packaging on no age statement whiskey, the whiskey most likely being mostly produced from the new distillery, which opened in 2018. Now, you can't sell 5-year-old whiskey at a premium, but you can sell a concept, a story, and packaging. And that's where the Distill Your World series really, really excels. The storytelling is brilliant. The design of the packaging is brilliant. It's all there, but the whiskey itself, it's no age statement. There will be some older whiskey in there to blend it up and bring the quality of it up. But broadly speaking, I think we're seeing so many of these no age statement releases because they just want to sell more of these products for more money. Welcome to capitalism, people. Now, the Distill Your World New York was originally released at $5,000 and it was released in an edition of 1,000. So it's not that limited really, people. The Carrizara Geishas, you know, the new ones are coming out, 38 and 40 year old whiskey at 219 and 129 bottles, and they're released at 25 and 30 grand. The secondary market has been paying between 12,500 and 18,000 pounds for these bottles of Distill Your World New York on the open market. Now, the prices have come back down, they're a bit more like 12,500 pounds, but that's insane. But all of that is caveated to say that the $250,000 bottle wasn't one of your standard Distill Your World New York bottles. So the first thing that really alerted us, or alerted anybody, to the fact that this was a special bottling was the estimate. It was in Sotheby's with an estimate of $30,000 to $80,000. It also stated that it was a one of two limited edition. Now, one of the bottles was being sold in Sotheby's and the other one was being recorded as being stored at the Macallan archive. Well, you know what? Whoop-de-doo, people. Every single time you release whiskey to the market, places like Macallan or the distilleries, etc., they all have to keep a sample bottle back in their archives. Now, this one was special whiskey. It was apparently 20-year-old whiskey, so it was from one of the single casks that went into the blend. So this one was a single cask, so one bottle from a single cask, a 20-year-old whiskey. But realistically, you were buying a limited edition box. Like, this one is no, it was a slightly different color, but there wasn't really that much fundamentally different, except a few more things. Now, you know, the winner of this lot, I'll read this out, they were granted, the winner plus three guests were granted a dining experience at El Salacan Rocco, a 3 Michelin starred restaurant in Catalonia, Spain. So look, you're going to get the red carpet rolled out to you. And there are a few other bits and bobs in there, but that still doesn't explain a $250,000 sales price. But there's one factor that categorically does explain this, in my opinion, and that is taxes. This, we'll put it on the screen now. This is from the IRS. Donors who purchase items at a charity auction may claim a charitable contribution deduction for the excess of the purchase price paid for an item over the fair market value. It was a charity auction, people, in America, where you can get tax deductions from purchasing at charity auctions. So the charity auction here was going to Cha Sha Ma. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Cha Sha Ma? Cha Sha Ma? It was basically, it's a cooperative sort of charity in New York, I believe, that provides affordable workspace for visual artists. Brilliant. Like, I'm really, really down with that idea. I studied fine art in my degree. I'm really down with that. But what does this mean? So this lot had a high estimate of £80,000. So the buyer of this lot was able to offset £170,000 of the purchase price, you know, the difference between the 80 and the 250, against their taxes. So they were able to do two things. They were able to make a massive whopping donation to a charity, which is doing loads of good things in the community, and they get the benevolence of being a really good person. They also get to offset a load of taxes. And it could also seem I have not looked into this too much. Are any American tax experts out there watching this? I think Macallan might be able to get a tax break as well on this. But anyway, but for this reason, this is why we didn't put charity bottles in our world record prices video, which we'll put on screen now. We did a video of all the world record breaking bottles at auction, but we specifically didn't include charity auction bottles. So there you go, $250,000 for essentially a 20-year-old whiskey in a fancy box. Don't take prices at face value, people. There's always another story behind the story that you read in the papers. I mean, in this case, it's great. A charity's received a whopping amount of money and everybody's done good. But if you're trying to see this and sort of use this for fuel of the fire for sort of like whiskey investment and stuff like that, whiskey investment is great, but look at these things in isolation and you always need that wider context and understanding.